Hi, and welcome to this installment of Pastor Training Videos from ChurchTherapy.com. I'm Kristen Kinsevich, licensed mental health counselor on staff at East Coast International Church in Lynn, Massachusetts. Today I'm going to be talking about cognitive behavioral therapy. It's probably something you've heard a little bit about because it's pretty widely talked about in and out of church settings. And I thought we could take a look at exactly what cognitive behavioral therapy is and talk about how you can apply it in your pastoral counseling sessions. So I wanted to start off first by saying that cognitive behavioral therapy is widely researched. There is a lot of scientific evidence for the fact that this mode of therapy really works. And another reason that I think it's helpful for us to talk about in a pastor training video is that it's very easily adapted to a Christian worldview. So there's lots of principles and good techniques that we can gain from cognitive behavioral therapy while really integrating that into our understanding of who we are as people and what it means for us to grow and change and be disciples of Christ. So let me give you a little bit of history first. In the 1960s, a couple different theorists, including Albert Ellis and Aaron Beck, began to talk about the way that our thinking and beliefs impact our emotions and ultimately our behavior. And so you see right there in the name, cognitive behavioral, that has something to do with the way we think and how that translates into action. And so typically a cognitive behavioral therapist will help a person identify what their thoughts and core beliefs are, not always so much just their rational beliefs, you know, what a person maybe says they believe, let's say, about the Bible. So I'm a Christian and I believe that Jesus is God and, you know, et cetera, down the line. We could recite various creeds if we want, but those kinds of beliefs tend to be rational beliefs. Emotional beliefs are a little bit different, and that's what I want to focus on today. These kind of core gut level feelings that may or may not line up with our rational beliefs. So sometimes we might, you know, believe a certain thing is wrong, for example, and yet we find ourselves doing it anyway. You know, Romans 7 certainly is a reflection of that, this battle between our flesh and our spirit. So if we think about our spirits being kind of awakened and opened with the Holy Spirit to the truth, that's our spirit. But then our flesh can carry with it some other beliefs that can then lead us down difficult or sometimes sinful roads, but really we're talking about things that fall into a category of what I would call life-controlling problems, where let's say a committed, motivated Christian is struggling with something, maybe overeating or maybe a sexual addiction or something like that, that in this case they would believe that the behavior is wrong. They would have often a continual cycle of kind of committing the sin or engaging in the behavior, and then repenting of that, trying to turn their ways, then doing it again, repenting again. And so they're kind of in this cycle. I've worked with many people who have been stuck in that kind of cycle for years, and they just really are at a loss for what else to do. And so this is where I think cognitive behavioral therapy can help us as we help people move forward spiritually as part of the discipleship process, to really help them get unstuck. A lot of times people know what to do to change, but they don't actually know how to go about bringing that change into their lives. So certainly cognitive behavioral therapy can go along with verses like in Romans 12, where it talks about being transformed by the renewing of our minds. Really, that's just one example of many scriptures we could apply here to say, really understanding the core gut level kind of sometimes subconscious beliefs that we carry around. Sometimes it's beliefs about ourselves, who we are. A lot of times that carries negative messages we've heard from our pasts. Identifying those is really important as we move along on a spiritual journey and transform our minds and really work. I think we're all in this process of gradually aligning our core gut-level beliefs with our spirit-led, you know, biblical truths. So we're kind of bringing things into alignment. And sometimes it requires some additional tools and techniques in order to kind of break through some of the barriers. So here's how I think that you could use this in a pastoral counseling setting, and maybe you're doing some of this already. Certainly the first step is to identify what a person's core beliefs are. So if they're having a problem, let's say overeating, for example, and they really want to stop, they've been trying to stop for a long time, and they have all kinds of self-image, body image issues with that, and they just feel a lot of shame. One of the core beliefs I would be trying to find out is, what exactly do they think about themselves? It may be that they had some core beliefs from childhood. Perhaps they were put down by their parents or abused in some way, or something like that. And so they're carrying already a sense that they're maybe not worthy, not loved. Now, this is sometimes pastors tend to want to correct this right away by giving them some verses to memorize, or, you know, just applying scripture right into that, which is can be a good thing. Certainly scripture is critically important to our spiritual lives. But it often isn't meeting the person exactly where they're at. Most of the time, they actually already know those verses, have tried to kind of apply them to their lives, and something's still stuck. And so we have to kind of penetrate that piece. And so by using cognitive behavioral therapy, what we would be doing is walking through kind of, instead of trying to just change the beliefs immediately, we have to really take time to understand the root issue. So talking through childhood pain, understanding their experiences, and just listening through that, that can take a while. And sometimes pastors may not feel like they have enough time to have the number of sessions they need to have to get all the way down to that point. But really helping a person unpack a lot of these things can be really critically important and really get at the heart of what their beliefs about themselves are. So that's really important to kind of identify what are those core gut level beliefs that they have about themselves, about the world, about their relationships. A lot of times people just feel like, well, you know, God's love is for, I believe that God loves us, and, you know, and I believe he loves me, but I don't know, I don't feel like his promises are true for me. So rationally they think that they're true, but emotionally there's something that is telling them they're disqualified. And so instead of just saying, nope, you're qualified, you're accepted, God loves you, to really understand what's the barrier, what's telling them that they aren't lovable or aren't worthy. And so then another piece of this I think that we can use is to identify what cognitive behavioral therapists call automatic negative thoughts. These are thoughts that most of us have that pop into our head that often stem from things we were told in childhood. Just your instant response to yourself on something. You make a mistake, oh, you're so stupid. Those automatic negative thoughts can be really helpful to identify. And once you've identified some of these negative thoughts or kind of beliefs that really, you know, again, the person knows aren't in line with scripture, but they just don't know how to kind of feel differently about it, then you begin to explore developing their understanding of themselves. And so what are their strengths? What are the things that, who has God made them to be? What's their true identity? Really understanding those pieces at a heart level, I think, is really important. Because again, that's where those core beliefs translate into our emotions and then into our behavior. So as a person develops confidence or works on self-esteem issues, for example, then they often begin to make some healthier, better choices. They can care for themselves in a different way, and they can move forward spiritually in a different way because they feel more free inside. And so that's really the goal here. One of my favorite verses is Galatians 5:1, which says, "It is for freedom that Christ has set us free." And so I think that's really always the goal, is that we want to get people unstuck. We want to use as many tools as we can to help do that. And we want to really meet people where they're at, instead of just applying scripture to their lives and expecting them to take it and kind of be able to integrate that into their kind of emotional palette. A lot of times healing is needed before a person can do that. So I hope that helps. There's loads more that you can read about cognitive behavioral therapy, just doing a simple online search. And you can always go over to churchtherapy.com and click on the Q&A tab and ask any questions that you'd like. I'd be happy to answer them. Until next time, take care.